All right, let's go. Episode 95, man. We're about to run it.
Yo, kick that 10% theme song.
Y'all better be ready. Yes.
Let's go. Give these people what they want.
Raise it off, raise it off.
Yeah.
Get your asses off.
DB in the house.
Yeah, yeah.
That guy right there.
When you come around here.
Yeah.
I show in your tears. You come around here. I'm vocalizing your fears. You talk about healing your wounds. I talk about putting down some hurt. You talk about planting grass. And I talk about getting in dirt. You talk about pain. And I talk about killing. I got a word I want you to know. And it's called revolution.
I should have kept it going. I should have kept it going, man. But y'all ain't ready for that.
Mm-mm.
You're not ready.
Mm-mm.
10% local heroes of San Diego, California, up and down the West Coast, just playing everywhere, playing like all over the place, man. In early, like what, like late 90s, early... Early like 2000s, man. Props to them, man. Like I love featuring local music, man. Shoot, man. We did Brothers from Another Planet. Shoot, man. Like now we're featuring 10%. It's only right, kid. It's only right.
It's like you
welcome
didn't
to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, yes. Welcome to the show. This is BK Bridge Kid, my man over here. This is AY the Wide Nose Bandit coming at you live and direct from Gregory Arm Studios. Woo!
Give it up, GA. B Street.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. We are back.
Young World, what's up? Live feeders, what's up? Subscribers, what's up?
How's it going, man? How's it been? How's it been for everybody?
Hey, man.
You guys doing all right?
We slow motion it, but we here, baby.
Shoot, man.
We above ground. We walking. Upright. You know what I mean? Knuckles on the ground, dragging.
Absolutely.
Keep it moving, man. You, yourself, how you feeling?
Doing all right, man. Doing all right, man. Just living the dream.
La Vida Loca, huh? You're with it, man.
Man, just working and, you know, just trying to stay above sinks, man. That's all.
3 feet high and rising.
That's all.
3 feet high and rising.
Simple. What's a moniker and shit? Simple motto?
There you go. There you go.
Simple
there you
theme?
Go. There you go.
Just live.
That's it, man. It ain't hard. Don't make it complicated.
Nah, man. It's just live and grow.
Right.
And yeah, just learn.
Be responsible.
Yeah, man. Just be humble.
You don't
man.
Know ask. But we are. What's up, J Rock?
Yes.
Good to see you, boy. We ain't forgot about you.
Yes.
How's the fam? Everybody.
As a matter of fact, man, John actually was serious about him living like in Guam now.
Yeah, he's like the head curator. What do you call that?
Director or something like that.
At some museum.
That's amazing, man.
It's crazy, right?
Keep doing big things, J Rock.
That's it.
Love you, man.
When you grow, you should grow. You know what I mean?
Got to,
don't
man.
Don't matter where.
Got to.
This fool just told me. He just literally said. Like, that's how powerful life is. He just told me a story where he said in his roof, he had a leak, came home, was trying to fix a leak, and found that there was some type of plant or mushroom growing in the roof.
And expanding the roof and, like, kind of pushing its way out.
Do you understand? It's not like a rose in the ground of a concrete. This is a life. In a roof.
Yeah.
Like that shit, like when it's meant to be, it's gonna be.
Yeah, man.
You can't deny it. You know?
It's rained a lot, so
but dude, risk.
Seeds and weeds and all kind of stuff just kind of just end up everywhere and things happen, I guess, man.
You need a little bit to lot to live. It's not complicated.
No.
You know, give me some root.
Right.
Give me some sun.
Right.
Give me a little water.
Exactly.
Check me out.
Simple.
Check me out. Watch what I can do. Right? That's all of us, too.
Yes, sir.
That's all of us. Yo, you guys are on episode 95 right now. This is called the Pre-Mid Y2K. It's in the name right there. 95, the middle years before going into the new decade of 3.5K, Y2K. I remember that was a big deal. People making a big, not us, but people making a big deal about it with the computers. How is it going to know to go to 2000? Why wouldn't it? Motherfucker, it's the next number up. It's going to zero out and the world's going to come to an end. We was rocking and fucking. We didn't give a fuck. Let it in. Sorry, my bad.
Wow.
Honest shit. You know,
I know, right?
We was rocking and having a good time.
Yes, we were. That's a nice hat, man. I like that.
Yeah, I got a black one. Same thing.
You want to hear something crazy?
What it do?
When I moved out here, the goal was supposed to move to Hawaii.
Yeah, you were supposed to come to Hawaii.
And set up shop.
Everybody, yep.
I never made it.
Yeah.
That was like 95.
94.
94?
Yeah. You supposed to come to 94.
Never made it.
Yep. The goal was in 93, everybody's going to come to Hawaii. But Clee had went home early in 93. He went home in October before we got out. Because we didn't get out until 94 in January.
That's like 30 years.
Yeah. Yeah. On the mark. And he said, you know what, man? I live in Oceanside. And I already knew about 91X and all that shit. He goes, man, I live 30 minutes away from San Diego, an hour from fucking L.A. He goes, this is where we need to be. Mm-hmm. He goes, yeah, we may be able to do what we want in Hawaii, but that doesn't mean it's going to work for us that way.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, sent old girl. When he was here, I was here in January.
It would have worked.
Maybe. I mean, it's not like it worked here. Well, you know what I mean? Like, I know what he was saying.
Yeah.
Back then, but yeah, we definitely would have made it work. Yeah. It just made sense, man. Plus, it was an easier move for you. So,
oh yeah.
And I was really the only one set up in Hawaii. It's hard to set up in Hawaii. You all would have needed to be. Well, maybe not please so much, but you definitely would have needed to be with me for a minute. Whereas here, we were with each other, but you could still do your shit.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. It was a little. It's less expensive. So.
If I was living in Hawaii, man, like I would have gotten a job, like as a dancer. Okay, an exotic dancer, making some greenbacks, making some quick cash.
You see your ass right now in the international market and shit with your little skirt on, banging bitches in the face with your love meat.
Yeah. Hey, man, I got to do what you got to do.
Sorry, man. It's a part of the show. Tip on your way out. Yeah, man, it would have been something. Who knows what happened?
Yeah.
I know I wouldn't have been as driven. I know that because I had everything. I was living a life of luxury out there.
Mm-hmm.
It was crazy, man. It was crazy. I mean, I don't know what the push would have been like. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like here, it was dire in a sense.
Yeah.
It was all like, man, get up, man, get out of this.
Yeah.
Whatever you're doing, get out there and try to make it happen.
You know
what I mean? There, it's like, yo, let's go to the beach. It was happening. It's just a beautiful place, man. So. But yeah, man, that's crazy. Yeah, me and Clee was just talking about that. Speaking of which, check your Discord. I think I sent you something. He didn't say anything about it. He said the 13th of May. He wants to get with me in here.
Oh, yeah, I answered.
So, okay. Oh, I didn't see it. That's my bad.
Yeah.
It's okay. Anyways, y'all know who it is. BK, Adui Yako, Wide Nose Bandit, man. We're trying to get to that 100 mark. We're going to get there. 93 has been a little, he's been busy. I've been busy. You know, we're doing what we do, man. There's no pressure, there's no fuss. We're going to bring y'all the music as we bring it. You know, we're going to give y'all what we're going to give y'all. Man, we're going to keep the shit coming. So just bear with us. Stay with us. Tune in when you tune in. And worst case scenario, man, what we haven't done, go back and do what we have done.
Right.
It's no biggie. There's a lot of music for y'all need to go back and realize, okay, let me listen to this again.
What about your music in intensity in the last month? Have you listened to a lot of music?
You know what? The last few days, well, last week I started jumping back in. But before, no, man, I've been doing a lot of, you know, family stuff and work stuff and a lot of CC stuff. CC's been getting a lot of, like, setting up her whole school thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, because she's straight. She's going to start taking a college course this summer.
She's
Psychology 101 at Southwestern.
Okay.
So, yeah, just like that, man. It's happening. Like, she's getting all these damn flyers and shit because she's got all these AP classes.
Yeah.
And so they think she's graduating, like, tomorrow. Like, you know, stop sending all this bullshit. Yeah, send me the scholarship money. Let me do that. If I can use anything, let me use that now. Shit. Like, she's 15 years old, man. What y'all doing, man? Check the fucking facts, man. But anyway. But yeah, I've been doing a lot of that, man. And just last week, man, because I thought we was going to get up. So I was like, you know what? I think I got out to episode 105. Beyond as far as folders go.
Okay.
But I hadn't really, but that was out of old content. But just recently, I've been able to, like, as you can see, I got about, there we go. I got a whole,
because the internet,
I got a whole bunch of new stuff, look at that I haven't even been able to get into yet. So, and I got that by listening to the,
ladies and gentlemen, he's shown me like a whole list of like, playlist that he still has to go through.
Yep, these are brand new. It's like 20 of them. Brand new. And I got those off of my Discover, which I hadn't listened to in a minute, and off of New Release.
Okay.
And I love those.
Guy listens to a lot of music. Yeah, a lot of new music.
So I got a lot of stuff, man. So got my like songs build up. So.
I'm going to ask you something controversial. Uh-oh. Would you say that the music, would you say that the new music that you're listening to, does it compare to like to great music? Would you say that is great music? Like, would you say that the music that you're hearing now is like better than a certain era of music that you thoroughly enjoy? Is that a fair question?
Because
like my friends and I talk about stupid shit like that.
I like this era. I mean, you know, the Stevie Wonder era.
Anyway.
You know what? I hear exactly what you're saying, because I know what you're saying. Mm-hmm. I know what you mean when you ask that question. Mm-hmm. It's such an open-ended question, though. You know what I mean? Like, it could go anywhere, just like asking.
How is the new music today?
To me.
Yeah, like, sum it up, like, in one word. In one word, man, because we got tracks to play.
It's funny you say this, man, because, like, 2 days ago, I was listening to my Discover, and I picked like four songs that were weird as shit. You know what I mean? Just left field.
Yeah.
But I don't know if that made them great, but I was like, you know what? And like, I put two in your folder because I got your folder. I bought BK's got to hear this. BK's got to hear this. Mm-hmm. But it's not like I'm saying, oh, wow, I need to listen to this. Like, I haven't had a Radiohead moment, a Rage Against the Machine.
If I do,
it's very rare. It's light. It ain't like, okay, here comes such and such. Okay, here comes blah, blah, blah. You know, so I know exactly what you mean.
Yeah.
But the new music that I do hear that does rip or open my ears up, I wouldn't have said this like a couple eras ago.
Say it.
But now, and maybe it's my age, the new music that I do like is interesting.
Okay.
That's the best way I can put it in one.
Okay.
It's interesting.
Interesting.
Like 30 years ago, if I said some new music or something, I'd be like, yo, that shit kicked my ass. Like how you talking.
Yeah.
Yo, B, it kicked my ass. I don't do that no more. I haven't had a couple, maybe five albums out of what, 20 years? That I can, or 10 years, and I can be like, yo, that shit wore me out, bro. It made me want an album, just make a couple of songs. I can't remember last time an album, I listened to a whole album, like, yo, fun! And that's just what it is. Not a diss, though. That's just me.
On that note, thank you.
No worries.
Thank you.
No worries.
Let's get to some tracks, man, which we have each compiled. We're going to play a format of two from me, two from you, mm-hmm. and then two more, and two more. Mm-hmm. A total of six from me and six from you.
Boom.
There.
It can count.
There is an artist here that I'm going to play today that I heard, and it excited me.
Say less.
I'm going to see like if you can guess it.
Say less.
All right.
Let it ride.
So once again, this is episode 95. Thank y'all for like sitting through. The episode is called episode 95, Pre-Mid Y2K, with your boy BK and AY, the Wide Nose Bandit. Let's get right into it. This is round one. We'll be right back.
Send me before we play. Because I don't have your song.
Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Let's go, everybody.
It should update it, though, when you put your... When you...
Stop raising your voice for me. Stop messing around with my sanity. Got me in the bubble, I can barely breathe. Must be a mixture of the licking trees. Stop walking away from me. Don't try to show you all this man to be. Break bread, make bread, and lavishly. Trying to make you happy, enjoy life like comfortably. Got me wigging, making bad decisions. Never said it was perfect, but I belong to no one. Baby, you should know that. Never try to play you, let alone betray you. Later news, shit don't last forever. You show me best, releasing much aggression through rough sex. A mess, yes I am. 4 to 5 years, I committed the best I can. At least I thought I was, sure I was. Daughter love got me master twisted. Love for you was artistic. Mothership, I must have missed it. Not feeling you. Snip that shh instead of flipping. What's wrong with people nowadays? They don't listen. Stop raising your voice in me. Stop messing around with my sanity. Got me in the bubble, I can barely breathe.
Yeah.
She signals me outside, and so I walk through the road, and I meet her by the streetlight, and then she leads me to the beach, and we sit there for a while. But when the sun climbs the sky, she leaves me for the moonlight.
Thank you. That was very pretty. Very pretty.
Round two. Round one's out.
Yes.
One's out. What you do, BK?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. That was round one, WPI, episode 95. Y2K is in the house. Mid Y2K is in the house. I kicked it off with a song called Voistress.
Yes, he did.
And it's by Truth E No Lie.
Yes, it is.
Which is backwards for Alone. With my boys, De La Soul. This came out several years ago. It was supposed to be on his album, his solo album, Truth E No Lie. He's somebody which just used to hang out with, like, you know, De La. Probably somebody just from the neighborhood. They got him a record deal, and he was supposed to come out with a full-length album, man, but this song sadly just appeared on a, like, various artists compilation, but I found it, man, because, like, I'm a big De La fan, and I like digging for all of their rare cuts. They did this song with him, and it's dope, and unfortunately, we didn't get to hear them rhyme on it, but Truth kind of starts off the track, and that's what I featured today, man, because I wanted to give my man some shine. You know what I'm saying? Truth E No Lie. The song is called Voistress. Cool cat, cool track, very chill. It's got, like, horns in it and all that stuff, man. It's dope, it's dope. Right after that, there's this chick that I found who is very interesting, and her name is Liv, but it's spelled L-I-V period E. L-I-V dot E, but it's pronounced Liv. It's off of her album, Wild Animals. Actually, the song is called Wild Animals. I'm so sorry. It's off of an album that she has out right now that just came out recently, and it's dope. She's from Dallas, Texas, and she is a neo-soul artist, and I don't know what it is about neo-soul, man, but I seem to fall into that realm recently. Of late, man. Like, I really like that type of music. Anything like with alternative R&B, for whatever reason, man, I am gravitated towards it. And I got to hear what they're doing, man. Because, like, I'm always looking for the next sound, the next big thing. Liv, that track right there, Wild Animals, man, it was featured on a alternative R&B playlist. And I heard that song, and R&B could get kind of repetitive, but when I heard that song, man, something about it, man, with the piano and, like, just her voice and the beat and man, something about it was just so fresh and light and just overall dope. By the way, she has an album out right now called Girl in the Half Pearl. Mm-hmm. And when I saw pretty much the name of the album, man, like, it just drew me in. It just drew me in. All together. Anyway, she's based out of LA now, and if she ever, you know, comes here live, man, I'll check it out. I'll definitely check it out, man, because I feel like no, I don't think so, man, because she has a lot to offer as an artist, and I just feel like, you know, she's got something, man, which I think is about to be not huge, man, but just kind of underground. Mm-hmm. On the underground level. Kind of, sort of, man. Yeah. Mm. Very, very good take, man. Now that you mention it, I could dig that. I could see the similarities. And he is referring to Erykah Badu, which is another one of my favorite artists. So. Yeah. All right. Well, anyway, once again, her name is Liv. The song was called Wild Animals. Check out her album. It's pretty dope. Anyway. That was my set.
Before I go into mine, let me ask you this.
Yes, sir.
Piggybacking off the question you asked me before going into those first two. Yeah, come on. It's easy, though, for you. Watch. When someone speaks to you about newer music or something new that they heard, or when someone says, yo, man, you have to check this out, what is your initial emotion to that request or that what you hear that person saying or asking you?
I'm gonna sound like an asshole.
You keep it real.
Doubt.
You know, like isms. You're right.
Whatever. I've heard it all. What do they got? I'm not impressed, but then I'll check it out and I'll listen with an open ear. And if I hear something fresh, and fresh to me usually comes from a lot of alternative music, like postmodern stuff. That's where I hear artists doing the most reaching, the most stretching. And I could appreciate that. So when I hear somebody do it right, that excites me. It seriously excites me, man. Like I get like goosebumps, like, oh man. Because listen, just really quickly, y'all. Just let me just say this. When I first heard Q and Not You, I couldn't wait to tell you about them and Klee and everybody that I knew. I was like, you may not like this as much as I do, but I hear something amazing.
You cannot deny this thing right here. Yeah. It's undeniable. You may not go out and buy a record or go to the show, but this song here,
I like fully endorse it. And like, you know what? When I first heard In The Poll, I got excited about that, man. I was like, yo, you got to hear this band. Anyway.
Very well. See?
I'm a nutcase, but it's okay, man. Like, I like it. It's all right.
Motherfucker's honest. He honest.
Doubt's my word.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Like you know, thrill me.
You got it.
Bring it. Yeah. I'm like, bring it. Let me hear.
What you said,
please.
Yo, my first track was by the Brazen Youth. I played a track from them before a while ago. This one was called Figure in the Field. It's off their album Primitive Initiative from 2018. Their last album that they made was called Ego Idaho. I went into their whole spiel about where they're from, how they came up with the concept, how they write their songs, how they're a band that's not necessarily brothers by blood, but they're brothers like in relationship, in life. So they're real tight. They like to go places like Abstract, sit there, record, write, play, and then take it to the studio. So I like their process. I'm not going to go into too much more about them and stuff. Once again, that song was Figure in the Field by a group called The Brazen Youth. That I like their arrangements. I like their ideas. Off the album Primitive Initiative from 2018.
Check them out. Is it a band or?
Yeah,
or
a band.
Okay.
Yes, sir. They got new song out too, and it's called.
I was wondering like if it was like a Billy Corgan type thing.
No, they're good.
Like I am the leader, and everybody just follows me. Okay,
they're a full on group. They got a new song called out. Called it's the latest single release. I haven't even heard it yet. Oh, it's called I've never killed anything that lived. So I can't wait to hear what that sounds like.
Okay.
I kind of like that title. Anyways, the next song was called Breath Chant by an artist called Johnny Nash and another artist called Suzanne Kraft. I played you Suzanne Kraft before. It's a guy named DJ Herrera. He's based out of LA. Does a lot of cool lo-fi type guitar riffs with that Dinosaur Jr. pop sound almost, but with a different undertone because of the speakers and the drums that he used. I like his ideas. He teamed up this dude, Johnny Nash. He's another well-known cat in that genre of music, man. Kind of have that James or Dean Blunt feel to it from overseas, but it's more here. This is their version of that here.
Okay.
Good artist, man. Breath Chant is just a single that they released together. They're like-minded artists, they get together, collab, do some things together. And what year is this? I think this is this year. Let me make sure. I forgot to look. I'm sorry, guys. Bear with me. it's a good track. I love the openness of it. I love the guitar. I hear a lot of things that I would do or things I could do on it. Whenever I hear music like that, I know it's not necessarily it's good. I know it's me. And I like that. I like to be connected with other people, even though I have no idea what they're about. But musically, there's no denying. You know what I mean? It's like the perfect wall breaker to everything.
Yeah.
So I love that. Anyway, this song, Breath Chant, is actually from 2020. That's my bag. It's a single. Once again, that's Johnny Nash and Suzanne Kraft. Check it out. Check them both out. They got a lot of bodies of work. They got a good body of work that y'all can go through.
Dope.
So those are my two. Those are his two.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That was round one.
Keep it flowing. Bring it up.
Let's jump right into round two. Let's keep it rolling.
Hawaii, you
feeling
all
right? You feeling
good?
Good. All right, let's keep this rolling.
Yeah.
We're going to hit you with some more flavor. I'm going to drop two. He's going to drop two more, and then we'll be right back, all right?
It's like I done done this before. You know what I mean?
Let's get to it. I'm going to hit you with an old school banger right now because I feel like it.
That time, it's about that time to get paid, get laid, cool in the shade, drink a little bit of lemonade. Let me tell you what I want. Yo, I wanted this to be special, something more than any other feeling that you felt before. Pushing through the doors, I see girls having a good time. I might say a rhyme, old school, new school, no school rule. But other than that, everything is cool. I see guys and girls dancing, doing the new dances. That's a hit while I'm over here romancing. You ain't shh, it's no need to curse. Ask me who she is and let me tell you first. Slow down, be cool, and don't act ill. I came to have a good time, party and chill with you. And don't worry, sweetheart, I'm still with you. And after we leave, we will continue with our plans. My plans are made to be broken, smoking. I'm not joking. Try to diss me and I'll give you a token. Cause I'm the type of brother that can't be stopped. And no matter what, I'm gonna
kick,
while my mind say,
give it all you got, give it all you got.
Come on. Yeah.
The Get Fresh crew.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yo, yeah. Yeah. Now the music is bumping. Good atmosphere. Jamal and Barry B, they must have beat me here. There in the booth, which is all soundproof. Playing dope jams.
That's a party track right there, boy.
That's how you get motherfuckers smashed.
We never know each other.
Can
you ever tell just what we were called in this world? I stand on the edge of a broken sky.
We'll be right back.
7-Eleven betting on myself. I need boats in the Gulf Coast. Shoe fly, I'm in a soup kitchen. Who else? The fly. I did enough, nothing more to say. Get your stupid ass blown away. Self-defense, if I'm not mistaken. The cops support a break-in. Found the body when they got there. I'm not there, it's not clear who did the shooting. Rappers prostituting, check your prostate. I cop my clear in 03. I'm good bread, nigga, gluten-free. Stone Island, 10 years ago, you gotta know. I don't give a flying fuck about none of these niggas, not a damn one. I'm in a different space, you get your face grazed. Meanwhile, I'm on a Zoom call with Samsung. I went corporate, still fucking groupies. Slumdog millionaire, you get air for a couple rupees. It's not a movie.
From the moment I walked out of the car, I felt like a million bucks. Catch me if you can.
Very exciting. Very exciting indeed. Welcome back. That was round two of WPI. We played. I'm your boy BK. This is my man. To my right, AY the Wide Nose Bandit.
Damn right.
We're sitting through some like dope tracks. I love doing this, man. This is so much fun, man. Hearing like, you know, different takes on like just people just taking beats and taking grooves and samples. Some people are actually playing instruments. Man, music is it's amazing, man. It really is. It really is, man.
Anyway.
Shoot. Ah, man. So let's get into round two. I jumped it off with an old classic from 1988.
Yeah,
off the album The World's Greatest Entertainer, and that is none other than my man Dougie Fresh and the Get Fresh Crew. Mm-hmm. The song was called Keep Rising to the Top. I like was on Instagram the other day, and somebody actually name dropped this song and they recommended it, and I went back to listen to it, and I was like, man, this song is hot to death. You can play this right. Well, I don't know about kids these days, but
you know,
if I had a house party of a bunch of Wades and like AY the Wide Nose Bandits, this song would come on, and I guarantee you everybody would be like, oh snap!
It would be sweaty as fuck in that bitch. That motherfucker was over it.
This song reminds me of freaking Town West in Houston, Texas. At a house party, my cousin and I, and it turned into like a shootout. But before the shootout,
it was amazing.
That party was on.
It was
fire.
Amazing.
The DJ was killing it. He played Eric B, BDP, Dougie Fresh. I mean, like Cinderella, Dana Dane, all of that.
Not,
stuff,
not to
man.
Cut you off.
Special Ed.
You know how I knew Texas was gonna be different. Oh. Texas was the first time, because remember back then there was no black movies that showing how life was for us or whatever.
Yeah.
Texas was the first place I went to where I saw black kids do a party at a house. Not an apartment.
Right.
Not their big mamas. Such and such. It was like a house. Somebody's parents left.
Yeah.
And they were like white kids throwing a party, but it was all black. It was amazing.
It was so much fun.
I was like, this shit is gonna be all here.
So much fun, man.
Oh man.
Houston, Texas, man. The old Houston, Texas man was pretty fly, man. Well, man. Better yet, we made it fly.
God dang right we did.
We made it fly. Mm. All right. So anyway.
Mouthful.
I just wanted to give Dougie Fresh props, man. Thank you. Thank you for like making like a banger back in 88 that still holds up.
Yeah, you did.
Classic, man. So anyway, keep rising to the top, Dougie Fresh. Right after that, I like hit you with a curveball, and I hit you with Portishead. And this was off of their third album called Third. And the song was called Hunter. This song haunts me. Let me just say that when I hear this song and when I listen to this album Third, you made a comment about how, like, in the middle of the song, man, like they come up with the
right?
Has nothing to do with the song.
Right.
But when you go back and listen to that whole album, every song has a siren.
Yeah.
Has a and it's tense.
Yeah.
You don't feel comfortable when you hear stuff, but every song, like on this album, has a moment like that. That it's some kind of calling.
Yeah.
It's an alarm.
That album sounds like a soundtrack.
Yes,
that
it does.
That whole album sounds like it's a soundtrack to some movie that we don't know about.
Yes, it does.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It sets up scenes.
Yes.
Every time.
For
I'm
sure.
Sorry. My bad. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Sorry.
Anyway.
Keep it to songs. I can't help but to comment.
The song is called Hunter. The group is called Portishead. Again, one of my favorite bands of all time. Mm-hmm. It's obviously my sister's favorite band. She loves Portishead. Lives and dies by Portishead. But anyway, cool band there from England. They made music differently, man. They made music by, like, you know, like recording it like in a band, like in a studio, and then sending out that music out to get pressed on records, and then back to the DJ in the band, and then he'll go back and scratch it and, like, you know, manipulate sounds. Make some of it go backwards and all kind of weird stuff, man. But it worked. Late 90s, man. Hip hop was like exciting and new and fresh. This was Portishead's last album. It wasn't as good as their first two, but it still holds up and it's still dope in my opinion.
I really feel like this album was for them.
Yes.
Like they just, you know what? You've been doing this for a minute. Maybe
for sure.
Do it again.
Let's try something different. Let's change it up.
Let's get in this and knock it out the box.
Yes.
For us.
Yeah. Agreed.
Good two picks. Excellent two picks.
All right, my man.
I played you a song called Slower Hell from a group called Money. I played you them before.
Great song.
Off their EP called Money, the same name. It's got four tracks on it.
Great
the first
song.
Track I played was called Fucked. F-U-C-T. That was like about maybe 10, 12 shows ago. So I went back to the EP. I saw I had this song hearted. And I was like, you know what? Let me go ahead and put this song on here. It's been a minute. So,
there's a folder that I have with your stuff on it. And I slowly just moved that over to the side.
I'm
going to go back to that one.
It's an interesting little EP with four songs. But the first song and the last song, which is this one, are definitely the bangers.
Yeah.
They butt in and front in the hell out of that little EP. They got a new song that just came out that they just released. And it's called Flaco. But I haven't heard it yet. I'm going to check it out. Once again, this is from 2022. It's an EP called Money. The group is called Money. The track I played for you right there was called Slower Hell.
It's not a good name for it.
Yeah, you said that. Yeah, you didn't. You know,
Money?
You like they mailed it in on that one. That's what you said. That's what you said on the show. Like, man, they just mailed it in on that one. I was like, no, man, that's kind of tight, man.
Like yellow money, green money, or I don't know, something. Blue money.
Torch marks?
Come on, man.
Speaking of which, that's my next song. It's called Great Times.
Yeah.
Great Times from Willie the Kid, Beat On, off the album Torch Marks 3.
Yeah.
I've played a lot of Willie the Kid. You know Beat On. He's another producer, man. He's doing his thing. I'm not even going to that body of work or what they is, but y'all should know by now, man. I'm just going to keep finding tracks, man, because there's millions of novels that this guy has, his body of work, man. That little crew, that clique over there, man, in the East, what they be doing with their little sounds and their arrangements and their crate diving, man, it's hard to deny it. If you can open up a little bit to it, if it just hits your ear or your mind or your brain cells just a little bit, you're in. Because I've been in, man, probably since 2015, 16.
Yeah.
And that's how long they've been doing it. They kind of started that little era, that little sound. And to this day, man, I'll listen. When you talked about being innovative or new ideas, when it comes to hip-hop.
Excited. Yeah.
When it comes to hip-hop, I listen to those guys. I listen to the, you know, the Conways. Yeah. And
what are these cats doing lately?
Yeah, you know, when I hear them, I don't feel like I'm being let down. All this other stuff, man, I just maybe out of... It takes so many tracks for me to get that one track, you know. Mm-hmm. Unless you're Drake, the rest of the guys, I mean, they're hit and miss to me. Even Future and all of them. Even the more no, you know, Rick Ross. They're black.
21 Savage.
I don't even understand that dude.
Post Malone.
I don't even understand that dude. Yeah. I don't get your boys just dropped a new album. Ray Schmurder. Mm-hmm. They just dropped a new one and I was listening to it. And then, you know, it's kind of what they do, a little different, but I'm not like, oh, yo, I'm not dissecting. I'm not studying.
Yeah.
You listen to Great Times, that song I just played, that whole song, you were trying to tell me something. You're like, look, hey, B, check out these horns.
Yeah.
You know, check out this. You hear that string?
Yeah.
Like, it's, even though it's a simple loop, there's an idea there that's complicated. It's got something to it.
That whole Griselda click. Mm-hmm. One thing about them, man, is that when I hear their music, if I played you their music, or if I created something like what they're doing right off the bat, anybody would say, that is weird.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's definitely acquired taste, man. Yeah. But if you're willing to go on that journey,
yeah,
man, they have some great stuff, man. However, the one con to them is that I don't think it's for everybody.
Yeah, it's not. Yes, it's definitely
it's for like a certain ear. Yeah. And when that ear hears it,
yeah,
they go apeshit.
They will not put any of this on a radio. You will never hear this on a radio.
Right.
You don't hear none of the DJs on the radio stations or the YouTube stations or the Instagram.
Right.
None of them are going to be like, yo, man, check out this. It's almost like an underground but known. Like, I don't understand how people popularize things nowadays, mm-hmm, but mm-hmm. I see the movements mm-hmm. of it. You know what I mean? So I don't even really know how to mm-hmm. express it in dialogue, but.
But they're doing it, man. Yeah, so yeah. I like coming. Respect it, man. Like, yeah. I like it. I like it.
That's 2-2, round two.
All right.
In the bag.
Let's get into round three, y'all.
Close it up, man. Let's
I'm very excited up. About this
Sip
round.
These motherfuckers up, man. Let's put them in the
all
bag,
right.
baby. Put them in the bag.
So I'm not even going to load it up in like, you know, preface it or say anything about it, man. I'm just going to drop the tracks, man. I'm going to hit you with two. He's going to come back with two bangers, and then we'll come back and just wrap up the show. All right? Let's get it started. All right, round three, WPI, episode 95, Mid Y2K.
Pre.
Nighttime. This is dedication to my whole crew. Those that's true, they all know who. This is dedication to my real crew. They all know who. The ones that's true, dedication to my whole crew. Going back a couple years, before the tears and the fame. Bussin'. You got a quarter family, me neither. The G's freeze broke, splitting one slice of pizza. Medina never seen a crew as fly, bumping. Saying something fresh, fucking labels keep fronting. Ain't nothing, we bout to make it, take it if we gotta. Now I got a daughter, do or die time, writing rhymes on the rug. Four to a room, it's all love, we don't bug. Same time Terrell caught a slug. I sold time, muscle chime in the city. Ain't got dimes for the weak, no pity. Shitty ass rap, need a firm gun clap. Revolution time, I'm cool like that. Go pop, I would never act a fool like that. I'm a panther, to a 666, I'm cancer. Blow up time, magazines, TV. Mad shows, flows, airplanes overseas. Cash on point, but I'm still on the D. Now I fell in L with a flower, never let her blossom. Love, I want some, she got some. Make life, same time take life. Now it's gone, but the shit goes on. Comrade click, memories stand strong. My joints go unpeep for the brains I borg. I live in eternal health for this pain I cause. Yes, yes, sure, it's true, we got the Grammy. Blast, blast, fool with my pound chrome jammy. Media clowns never did understand with
polish about them, man.
I'm in love with broken girls, 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 hey girl, 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 girl. I'm in love with broken girls, 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 girls. Girls, hey girl. Really I'm broke myself, and I think she might help. Really I love a story, and I think she might tell. Really I'm not your crutch, really you're not my girl. Really
really she using me, but it's cool, we use each other. I'm in love with contemplating about depression, conversations about depression, confrontation, cause we care too much about each other. We know it ain't permanent, but temporary, releasing your Easter egg insecure. Collect them like Pikachu, Venusaur. We go till you done on my penis, or sleep with the TV on, then we don't speak no more. And I know when I'm with you, or maybe when you're with me. Even if I don't feel a thing, for a second I feel complete. I still keep my back pocket. I know that I'm not shit, I know that it's toxic, I know that apocalypse, that was where your heart is. I'm in love with broken girls, girls, girls. Hey girl, 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 girl. I'm in love with broken girls, 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 girls.
Right.
If I fall short, don't make the grade. If your expectations not met in me today, there's always tomorrow, or tomorrow night. Come on,
come on,
hanging there, baby. Sooner or later, you know I'll get it right. Please, don't give up on me. Don't you dare give up on me. Yeah. I know it's late. Late in life's little games. Oh, but my feelings, my true feelings for you will never change. Here in my heart, my heart, my heart, my heart, I know I've been wrong, wrong. I'd like to make amends for the love and the hug and the tenderness that I've never shown. Don't you dare give up on me. Every word I speak tonight is true. Come on, I'll give you my everything, give you my heart, give you my love. You can have my money if you want it to. Please, don't give up on me. Oh, baby, we can make it, we can make it. Hold on, please, don't give up on me.
Grown folk shit right there.
The rain's on the wall looking like a work of art. AOP, they on the same shit. We off that. I'm gone. Okay, 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 there's ice in my heart. Fire in my veins. No light in the dark. Still a player remain. Gordy chain came from flipping cane. Back when I was running game. Back to back, double headers. Yeah, niggas think I'm playing. We are not the same. I bear the most, so feel the pain. I'm usually on my own and shit. Could be going out the same. Born alone, die alone. You ain't on the level I am on. They've been waiting for the answers I provided for. Throw it to the riches. If you wanna, you can ride along. Revving heavy engines. I been rubber till my tires gone. What's the life without some risk? No, you'll never be. Either way, be gone, ball. You can never stop my rain. It's the calm before the storm. Pure butter off the farm. That's the shit that I was on. Hot. It was just me on the humble, fitting the pieces, the puzzles. In the city where they hating, but be acting like they love
you. I hear you, Jukes.
Niggas is acting like they love you. Same shit. Fake hugs, fake love from fake thugs.
Word.
Ghosts. Fire weed in the firearm. Cool nigga like fuck it, who should I fire on? Saw a hell rider on fire, went for the ride along. All I do is get more smoke to drag the high along. Can you see pain in my eyes? If I see pain, all I really need is a mic, a few weed strains. Ever seen a heart get broke, to get restrained? The players ain't the same when the lead change. I
thought about the jukes on the D train. Then I told jukes, I'm like money on the green range. These is grown man bars, they not teenage. I be fucking with niggas that lead the scenes.
Hell yeah. Sometimes you know, sometimes you don't.
All right. All right.
Bangers.
Like I said, man, this guy always hits us with bangers to end the show.
Bangers.
Appreciate you for that.
You heard what he did.
Appreciate you for that.
About to tell y'all.
So round three, man, was very intense, man. I love it. I love it. I opened up that last set, man, with Dedicated, and it's by Diggable Planets. This wasn't featured on any of their albums, but it was on their greatest hits, Beyond the Spectrum.
It's a good song.
Song is just dope.
Yeah.
Just a nice, clean, dope track. Butterfly just spitting on it, man. Diggable Planets to me is one of those bands that they're popular, but like I felt like for whatever circumstances, man, they kind of missed the chance to be huge. Like huge in like Tribe Called Quest and now De La Soul huge. To me, Diggable Planets, I don't know like if they took too long between albums or if it was just the label in battlements. But something about them, man, like it's almost like they didn't reach their full potential. Would you agree with me?
No, you said this before, though. But we talked about it. Not that I don't disagree with you.
We're kind of talking about Arrested Development, too. Huh? Kind of lumped them in the thing.
Exactly. But you said it, too. You felt like they didn't push their album enough, or they didn't do more.
Or maybe they didn't understand it, didn't have any singles. Or
I don't know. I don't know what it was, but I know in the group, though, too, they were like, wanting to go different ways, Splinter. You know what I mean?
So yeah.
I don't know if it was a group thing. I know the label screwed them off the top.
Okay.
And that was the first thing. But when they dropped the Blowout Comb, I didn't think they were going to do anything else then either, because that album just had, it was too, I don't know, not unfriendly, but it was unpop friendly.
It didn't have any singles.
Very unpop friendly.
Yeah.
Which to me is awesome.
Which was better,
right? But
it was great.
Now that you brought that up, I'm glad you brought this up. Mm-hmm. So let's go to why did Tribe get so much love? They had a good, their record there wasn't that much better, but they didn't really have, I mean, radio friendly songs. It's just something about them. I felt like the songs work in a particular way. I felt like De La did come up with like, okay, I'll give you this, mm-hmm. but here's the rest of our shit. I never felt like Tribe ever really made and Midnight Marauder. The songs are nice, but I don't think they were pop songs or radio friendly. It's just some songs just happen to go, like Eagles to Go, or you know, but still
Lyrics to Go.
I don't
Electric Relaxation.
Like you could have did that with some of Dale's, or some
Diggable Planets.
You know what?
Yeah.
I don't know why they got
so much push.
I don't know why they got pigeonholed like that.
Yeah,
I don't know why that happened. You know,
maybe Tribe Called Quest stuff was more radio friendly.
Yeah.
Because like when you think about their hits, man, like you know, they did have some monster hits. Check Your Rhyme was a hit.
Yeah, but I don't feel like they made, hey man, we need to have this hit for this because of the radio.
Yeah, true.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I feel like De La did it just to fuck around because they knew they was in a bad deal and they were like, you know, we gotta get somebody somehow.
Yeah.
Like, give them something, you know? Not Tribe. Tribe always had their own little sound. They if anything, you know, Fife is trying to prove that he can rap. Mm-hmm. Fucking Q-Tip is like, yo, I'm Kanye West before Kanye West.
Yeah.
He just, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
but he wasn't an asshole where you could hear everything he was doing because of social media or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, it was a lot of shit there, man.
Yeah.
A lot of shit. This motherfucker had diabetes.
Yeah.
The DJ was...
well, what's interesting is that Tribe Called Quest, man, like they're being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame this year.
Mm.
Like before De La Soul and Diggable Planets and all these other acts. And yeah, I mean, like, I see what you're saying.
It's just weird.
Yeah.
They never were like, yo, man, we got to put this.
Yeah, they never stood out
on the chart. Yeah, they were never that.
Yeah.
But you know, they had shit that was just popular. I never understood that. I never understood why. Because the only reason why, I told you this before, I feel like the rebirth of Cool, pigeonholed Diggable Planets. And I feel like it was their Radiohead moment. Like, Radio didn't want to do Creep.
Right.
But that, damn it, man, that's how people got to know you.
They look so with, like, you know,
Myself
and I.
But see, that's okay, though, because they knew that was what it was going to be.
Yeah.
I don't think Diggable Planets wanted to rebirth the Cool to be that. But everybody else, the label included, like, you need to do more of this.
Yeah.
And that, the blow-up count was not that at all.
No, you're exactly right.
And I feel like that really But you said it too, though. You said the blog code may have took too long to come out, even still. But was that on them or was that on the label?
Exactly.
Because they didn't like what the shit was on. Yeah, so I don't know, Lee. I always think about that, though. Because they should have been, they were huge with that Rebirth of Cool shit. Cool like that, Slick like that, whatever the fuck the shit is called.
Yeah, this year, as a matter of fact, man, the reason why that I wanted to feature this is that, like, I wanted to give them shine, man, because this summer, they are celebrating their like 30-year anniversary of like, you know, their debut album.
Yeah.
And they're playing a whole bunch of like jazz festivals and all of this stuff, like, you know, with a live band. We've seen them live before and they're great.
Beautiful.
But it's interesting that now, like, you know, now people are like, hey, you know, Diggable Planets is really cool.
Right.
They got different shit. Let me check it out. And like De La Soul right now in the UK, they're like top five on the billboards, like with a 30-year-old album. Wow. They have in the US, man, they've had 12 million streams. People have been streaming their music like crazy.
Yeah.
They have blown up again on a 30-year-old album. Yeah. It's crazy to me. The music industry is like on a whole other thing right now, man. It's weird. But anyway, moving on really quick, man. Sorry, man. We went off on a tangent, man, but you know, That's what the show's about, you know? So right after that, man, like, I hit you with this song called Broken Girls. And when I heard this song, I, like, fell in love with it, man, because I have dated a lot of broken girls in my past. So I, like, connected with this song. Anyway, this guy's name is Saba. He's from Chicago. He's down with Smino and No Name and that whole Chicago clique. They ended up forming like a little super group called Ghetto Sage or something like that. Anyway, this is off of his 2018 album called Care For Me. I listened to this whole album. This is the guy that I wanted to see. This is the one. This album kicked my ass when I heard it.
I thought it was going to be him or Liv. Either way. Yeah. So, go ahead.
This album kicked my ass.
Broke you
now,
up.
I've listened to... This album springboarded me to listen to his more recent stuff and his older stuff.
Yeah.
But this album right here, man, this is the one, man, that I was like, man, I just heard the future of hip hop and R&B and I don't know, like there's another thing called Lorem and like Pollen and all these Aloe and all of these other like names of like new tunes and like new music, new sound.
Yes.
This shit kicked my ass.
So let me ask
Care For Me kicked my ass.
You said you listened to a couple before and a couple after. So does he continue forth?
Well,
or did he build correctly from where he came from?
Well, this is the thing. Thank you for mentioning that, man. Like I did say 2018, he dropped Care For Me and I loved it.
Right.
Everything he's done since, it's okay. Like, I feel like, I almost feel like the label is like, hey, man, why don't you go in this direction? Why don't you come up with, like, 10 songs
that
everybody connects with?
Mm.
And, like, I feel like this album, man, was like me sitting here, like, in my studio making my own album for me.
Free.
Free.
Yeah.
Nobody's bothering me. No one's, like, expecting anything.
Mm-hmm.
And this is it. This is the album that fucking grabbed me, and I was like, "Oh shit,
okay.
This is fucking dope." Mm-hmm. But yeah, his later shit, it's okay.
But the
he
body
changed
work,
a little bit.
The body of work is in Care For Me.
As yes. Far as
what type of artist?
Yes.
It's
what I what empire. What I think he should be.
It's his evil empire.
Thank you.
I got you.
Thank you.
I got you.
Thank
I'm
you.
With you. All right.
All right.
I need that.
That's all I got, man.
You said 2018 Care For Me, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right.
So. I close it up, man. I came right in, man.
Two bangers.
The man is named that you heard, the grown-up adult male man you heard singing. His name is Solomon Burke. He died recently.
Respect.
The song you heard was called Don't Give Up On Me.
Yeah.
Now, this came up on me because, one, I knew he had died. And when I was a young boy, my grandmother on my mom's side, we call her Big Mama, her name was Rayola Wims.
Mm-hmm.
She was a little woman. God-fearing woman.
R.I.P.
She took a lot in life. She came to us from the South she came out of Ohio via, I can't remember where in the South. It was either Alabama or Arkansas. I can't remember which one.
Mm-hmm.
And somehow, some way, she ended up moving over to Michigan. And lady had 12 kids. 8 boys, 4 girls. One of them my mother. And this woman would talk about this man on the radio she would hear sometimes. And it was always on these gospel stations. And I didn't really tune in too much, but I did tune in because I always listen to music. But she always talked about Mr. Burke. And I always remember that, man. Mr. Burke, you know, this guy, he never had a hit, top 20 hit, but he was on Atlantic. And he had a lot of singles. And he is very much an innovator for that sound that came in the mid-50s, late-50s, growing up into Motown. Motown stole a lot of that sound from Atlantic and went over to Motown in the 60s and stuff, which is all good because Motown, Detroit, Chicago, all that's right next to each other.
So. Yeah.
Anyways, Philadelphia, all that's right there, man. It's the trifecta where I call it Philadelphia, Detroit, and Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And this man, he wrote so many. He blended pop, not pop. He blended R&B, country, and gospel so well. And I always remember my grandma always talking about Mr. Burke. And when the song would come on, that was from my grandma right there, man. That's from my big mama, man.
That's awesome.
You know, heads up, man. Don't give up on me. That was live at the Montreux 2006. Rest in peace, sir. Rest in peace, man. Hope your journey has been pleasant.
Hell yeah.
Because you were definitely pleasant.
And helpful.
Definitely. Yeah. So, some grown man shit I want to throw in there, man.
That's dope. That's dope.
The next thing
you can hear his passion in the field, man.
You, like, you can hear his life.
He cares.
You can hear his life, right?
Exactly.
And you know,
I love it.
There's, what do you call it? You said humble. You always say humble.
Humble, yeah.
There's nothing but clarity.
Yes.
In that man's tone.
Yeah.
There ain't no bullshit, right?
That's what I fell in love about with Otis Redding back in the day.
Yeah.
I mean, like that brought me back to that.
Yes, sir.
Because Otis had that same intensity,
yes, sir.
The like same realness.
Yeah.
I mean, damn, just like you can hang on to every word, like, dude, this guy means it.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yep. It's like you got problems, but you listen to another person sing about problems and sing what they're gonna do about it, and you realize, you know what?
Yeah.
Like, it just totally, like, I get music now. I always got music, but I really get music now for not only why people listen to it, but I get it now why people end up making it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you're not sitting in the studio thinking, okay, Don't Give Up On Me is going to be this type of a song.
Right.
He just got his guitar out, or he sat on a piano, and these lyrics came to be, or the melody came out.
And just fleshed
and
it
And then
out.
All of a sudden, it just kicks. You know what I mean? It is a body. It is a life. It is a movement. And it's happening. That's why it's so much of it. Because there's so many of us, so many experiences. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I get it, man. I totally get music now, man. Once again, Solomon Burke, Don't Give Up On Me. That was live from the Montreux at 2006. The last song I hit you with is called The Same Shit. It's by King Jukes and Styles P.
Dope.
Some 2019 single. Styles P is the man. I ain't going to go into his resume. King Jukes is a guy that I don't know much about him. There's nothing in him. But he's got a body of work. Check him out. If you like that sound, he has a lot of work, man. Check him out. Listen to what he's about, man. I think the guy's really good, man. He's clever. He's clever, but he's very almost MF Doomish.
Yeah.
You know, you've probably seen this name before and didn't think anything of it.
Yeah.
Kept it moving. And he does it. He creeps up here and there, different places. And once again, this is an older track. This is from 2019, but I like the going back between him and Styles P. And I like the break. That when he ends his bars,
yeah, man, that
it's
bridge.
a bridge, and then it goes in the stop. I love that setup. That was just beautiful.
It's crazy. So,
once again, man, King Juke Style P, Same Shit, 2019, that's a single. That's it, man. That's pretty much 12 songs in a box.
Ain't it funny how, like, today's music, like today's hip-hop, like what you hear on the radio, and, like, what you hear underground here, there is so much heart and, like, so much musicality.
Yeah.
To the stuff that's not being heard.
Coinage.
And then the stuff you hear on the radio, man, like, it's so, like, almost disposable. I mean, like, it's good in its own way, but it's nothing like this over here.
I'm going to say something to that.
Uh-huh.
I can't even tell you 5 songs on the radio that are hip-hop songs right now. And, you know, I listen to the radio, not heavily, but, you know, every now and then I'll go through the channels. I can't tell you 5 of the most popular raps. Like, right now, if we pulled up Billboard and we listed 5 songs, we'll be like, oh, yeah, maybe I know that, or maybe I didn't know that. But if you listen to all of them, none of them will probably move you. None of them is going to make you go, let me check it out. And that's not a diss on pop music. That's just what it is.
It's just
what it is.
Yeah.
I feel like what you're trying to say really is, not trying to say, but what I feel like you're saying is, the gap between what's being exposed and what's not being exposed is huge.
Yes.
Compared to where it used to be.
Yes.
Right. Because I can listen. Yes. I remember maybe not knowing PJ Harvey back in the day, mm-hmm. but there's some group on the radio. I'm like, okay, they're kind of affiliated with her. Now we can make the link. Mm-hmm. You can't make no link to no damn King Jukes.
No.
Or really the kid.
To like 21 seconds.
There's no
connection. Or like Future.
It's not happening. So
or anything like, you know, Griselda to like
there's no
to like anything Chicago Common.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, it's weird. It's
well,
weird.
You know,
maybe, but it's a hard tie-in.
It's a hard tie-in.
Hard tie-in.
It's almost like you're listening to two totally different musics. Like I almost said the other day to somebody, like, this is hip hop and this is rap music. I don't know, man. Like I said.
Well, see, this is rap music.
Obviously, I sound like an asshole. But yeah, you know, that's my take.
Yeah, man.
That's my take.
Hey, man, this is episode 95, Pre-Mid Y2K. This is BK, man. Y'all know what he does. Y'all see how he gives it up. He don't play. He comes humble, and he lets you get smacked in the mouth because you deserve it. And we all deserve it. I'm Ay Wide Nose Bandit, man. So we play it, man.
Thank y'all, man. We went kind of long today, man, but it was necessary, man. Like, we haven't done this in a while, so it's fun getting back to this, man. So, like, you know, let's keep it rolling.
As always.
I'm BK, Ay Wide Nose Bandit, episode 95.
Absolutely.
It is called EP95, Pre-Mid Y2K.
There it is.
All right?
You heard what he said.
Y'all be easy.
Give him that outro music.
Yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Let's take it home, ladies and gentlemen. Have a great
and we're back at it, all right? Y'all be cool. I got my hieroglyphic pin on. I don't know if y'all can see it. But stay cool.
And let's keep it rolling.
2023. Hey, B, got a birthday coming up April 21st. Gonna be 40 years old. What's up? Oh, Nick. Oh,
what's up, man? All right. Y'all be cool. Peace out.